Rise to urge a yes vote for final passage of the Homeowners Flood Insurance Affordability Act. The legislation is, in essence, that we're considering today. And I'll say that the Senate went through a considerate, deliberate process where amendments were openly considered. I believe that at the end of that process, there was a 67-32 vote. We don't normally get two-thirds of the Senate agreeing on major issues, but we did at that time in a bipartisan effort. My understanding is that the legislation that ultimately we are considering today, which is basically foundationally what we agreed to here with some changes in the House, for which there was vigorous back and forth negotiation, passed by over 300 votes of the House of Representatives. So it seems to me that it has a broad bipartisan support and was vigorously debated in that chamber. We have an opportunity to once again, after the bill that we just passed, to show once again this body can work. We've had a respectable debate on good faith amendments that were germane to the bill and lived up to the ideals of the Senate when it was before us. We were able to have bipartisan negotiations to improve the House passed version of our bill so it provides the levels of relief that's necessary. And as a result, we're now poised to pass some critical legislation with, I believe, overwhelmingly bipartisan support, which provide real relief to millions of American families. And just very briefly, because I hope to basically not use all the time so we can come to a vote and get our members on their way, but this new legislation is, first of all, budget neutral. It does not add a dime to the deficit, nor does it hurt the solvency of the National Flood Insurance Program, and it prevents skyrocketing rate increases by implementing the following measures. One, it creates a firewall on annual rate increases. It repeals the property sales trigger that was depressing the values of homes. It repeals the new policy sales trigger. It reinstates grandfathering. It refunds homeowners who overpaid. And it has something that I think is incredibly important that I thought was so important when we passed Biggert Waters that I included by amendment in the Banking Committee, an affordability goal. Let us, yes, have the ability to ensure the solvency of the National Flood Insurance Program, but let us have an affordability mechanism, which FEMA was under the law that exists today required to report to the Congress so that we could ultimately come up with an affordability mechanism that would ensure that we have a solvent program and that we have an affordable program. Because at the end of the day, insurance is about spreading risk over a wide pool and in doing so, keeping rates affordable. Well, with rates that I heard from homeowners in New Jersey that went from $1,000 to $10,000 or $15,000, not only is that not affordable, but you're going to ultimately reduce the size of the risk pool in the National Flood Insurance Program. That means that's going to continue to drive up the cost, and you have a self-fulfilling cycle that ultimately does not provide for solvency. So we've kept some of the most important reforms under Biggert Waters, but we've created a window of opportunity to make sure we get to affordability, that we keep the real estate market at a time in which it desperately needs help to be able to continue to prosper, that people's most significant asset in their life. They build a lifetime to buy a home, and that's where they ultimately have their greatest asset. And that's where they leverage for their kids' education or emergency in health care, on a whole host of plan for retirement. And so for millions of people in my state and across the country who ultimately did the right thing, followed the rules, paid their premiums, met the higher standards, now to be told that in addition to, in New Jersey's case, the consequences of Hurricane Sandy, and throughout the Northeast, or flooding in Colorado, or the Mississippi, and a whole host of other places, that despite they did everything right, with no fault of their own, and having paid their fees, they are now with rate shock. inability to keep flood insurance, which sometimes triggers a default on their mortgage if they have a mortgage, or makes it impossible to sell their home. So that's what we are rectifying here in the Congress. That's what our collective purpose is. So I urge a strong yes vote. And finally, I want to thank my colleagues who have worked with me in a bipartisan basis, my lead co-sponsor, Senator Isaacson. I don't think there's anybody in the Senate who has a greater depth of knowledge in the real estate industry and how this legislation affects that, but also understands the consequences to individual families and has worked in an incredibly strong way so that we could get to this bipartisan moment. I appreciate all of his work. And I have to say, the tenaciousness and the ability to bring us to this point of Senator Landrieu, who has become an expert out of necessity from what happened in her state with Hurricane Katrina. The people of Louisiana are extraordinarily fortunate to have her as one of their senators, and she has been a guiding light throughout this process, tremendously helpful in getting us to today. And lastly, I appreciate the leadership on both sides to get us to this moment so we could have this vote. And with that, Mr. President, I yield the floor.